It's a well-known joke in the auto industry that hydrogen fuel cell cars have been the cars of tomorrow for about the past 30 years or so, with automakers promising us the metaphorical hydrogen-shaped moon on a stick, but never quite reaching the point where hydrogen vehicles, be they fuel cell or combustion, actually make it into production into any meaningful numbers. Of course, for the last 5 to 10 years, automakers, Honda, Toyota and Hyundai in particular, have tried to tell us how serious they are about hydrogen, spending hundreds of millions, sometimes even billions of dollars, on new hydrogen vehicle programs. Except that hydrogen economy we've been promised, you know, the big party for hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. Well, someone did something bad at the party and everyone's leaving by the back door. Will the last one out please turn out the light? Hi again, intrepid YouTubers. It's Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield here from Transport Evolved, and today we're going to be looking at the seemingly inexorable change in direction that many automakers are making as they turn away from hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicles and focus more on battery electric vehicles as they plan fuel of choice for the future. See, back in the late noughties, when companies like Tesla were really only starting to gain mainstream attention, and automakers like Nissan and General Motors are only really beginning to play with plug-in vehicle technology after a decade or more long hiatus, car companies were doing one of four things. Either they were sticking their metaphorical fingers in their metaphorical ears, screaming la 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 at the top of their metaphorical lungs and hoping to God that this newfound interest in cleaner cars would be replaced with a healthy love and respect for the roaring V8. Or they were ploughing money into so-called clean diesel technology, arguing that diesel engines were far better for the environment than petrol and had far better fuel economy than petrol engines. A few were cautiously following Tesla into the electric vehicle space, spending money on developing electric models that could manage just under 100 miles on a charge, could refill their battery packs in a reasonable amount of time using a dedicated rapid charging station, and could function as either a family's second car or as a primary mode of transport for those who primarily were based in urban or suburban settings. And then there were those who, either scared by battery electric vehicles or some other reason, opted to push towards hydrogen fuel cell technology, hoping that there would be some technological breakthrough that would lower the purchase cost, increase range, and give hydrogen fuel cell electric cars and their water vapor only tailpipe emissions a far more powerful place in the marketplace than a battery electric vehicle. Thanks to continual work around the world on lowering global emissions, not to mention the whole Dieselgate debacle, the first two options aren't really viable anymore, except for all but the smallest volume automakers. The battery electric option, meanwhile, has, thanks to improved battery cell chemistry, advances in production techniques, and a little company called Tesla and its Model S, become far more viable than it once was, with a whole range of plug-in models coming to market that can literally run rings, or at least lap, the majority of those first-generation plug-in cars of 2010 through 2016, which leaves hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. Toyota, true to hydrogen fuel cell from the very beginning, is now at least producing limited numbers of its Mirai fuel cell sedan for sale in key markets around the world, including parts of California, around London, and parts of Germany, as well as its home market of Japan. But with hydrogen fueling infrastructure still very much in its infancy and Toyota hand-making its Mirai fuel cell sedans in limited quantities, the Mirai is hardly going to change the world. And while Toyota is promising us a second-generation fuel cell vehicle by the time we go to the 2020 Tokyo Olympics, I'm very doubtful it's going to have a major impact. How about Honda? Well, Honda, as it turns out, has a very competent hydrogen fuel cell car on sale in the form of the Honda Clarity. In fact, the car is so good that the folks over at Green Car Reports recently said that it was the first hydrogen fuel cell car they'd driven that made them forget they were driving a hydrogen fuel cell car. That said, however, the Honda Clarity, like the Mirai, is only available in limited markets. And even then, Honda is building a plug-in hybrid and plug-in electric variant and is said to be focusing far more on battery electric vehicles than it once was. Hyundai? Same thing. It has its Tucson FCV, which is limited in sales and volume. And while it recently unveiled a concept version of a next-gen fuel cell SUV, last week it announced its intent to develop a brand new vehicle platform specifically for long-range battery electric vehicles with its sister company Kia. Which brings us to Daimler. Like Volkswagen and BMW, Daimler has been developing a hydrogen fuel cell division alongside its battery electric vehicles, hedging its bets, as it were. But during a German language automotive summit last week, the company's boss, Dieter Zeusch, said that hydrogen fuel cell vehicles are no longer part of Daimler's long-term plans. And that means, despite all the concept cars we've seen over the years, Daimler, and by proxy, its automotive arm Mercedes-Benz, is going for battery electric vehicles instead. And it's already announced a massive investment. Is there hope for hydrogen? Well, honestly, no. Battery electric vehicle technology has advanced so much and refueling infrastructure is so easy to install with less red tape than a hydrogen filling station, there's no competition. And then there's a matter of where hydrogen comes from. Most is made by steam reforming natural gas, while an increasing proportion of grid-based electricity is coming from renewables, which puts it at a disadvantage to battery electric vehicles. And then there's the cost of actually building those fuel cell stacks, and the efficiency differences between fuel cell and battery electrics. The latter is way more efficient. For passenger cars, then, the prospect isn't good. But for freight, well, that's a different matter. Although for decent power output, hydrogen fuel cells need some pretty insane amounts of cooling. Is it time to call the hydrogen dream dead? Well, probably in most of the world. But in Japan, where hydrogen is getting massive support from the Japanese government, we may see hydrogen outperform battery electric at some point in the not too distant future. The rest of the world? Solar panels on your roof? A battery, Tesla or otherwise, in the garage? It's pretty obvious which fuel source wins out in terms of sustainability and ease of use. Do you agree? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And you can support us through Patreon by following the link below or at the end of this video. And I'll be back tomorrow with more news from the world of cleaner, greener, safer, and smarter vehicles. Until then, I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep evolving!